We are at that point of the month again, you guys, the time that I love to film videos for you the most. And it's because I get to show you everything that was really good and I tried for the month and I was reaching for over and over again. And I'm so excited because I have a lot of new favorites. I have some really tried and true things. And then just a couple of things that are kind of random are coming in a part two that will be more along the lines of lifestyle, maybe some hair care, that kind of thing. And there's also some really cool Amazon finds in part two. So hello, YouTube family. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you like these kinds of videos where I do monthly favorites and I show you the very best of the month, please give this video a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. I would love to have you here as a part of our YouTube family. Let's get into the monthly favorites for January 2020. All right, so I'm going to first talk about skincare because I felt like I was delving a little bit more into skincare, watching skincare videos, getting recommendations, and just being really satisfied with a lot of the things I was learning. Now, I will tell you that I did purchase the whole entire line of Good Molecules. I purchased everything they have. And so far, I am in love with two of their products. This one is the Niacinamide Brightening Toner. And I want to read to you right on the front what some of the ingredients are. This is such a good toner. Does not dry me out, but it says that it's formulated with niacinamide, vitamin C, arbutin, and licorice root extract to brighten and improve the appearance of enlarged pores. Niacinamide is fantastic for refining pores, but licorice root, which is in here, is really good for brightening, and arbutin is too. So those all coupled together, if you have patchiness on your skin, dark spots, melasma, that kind of thing, this might be really good for you. Very, very cost effective. And I have been so enjoying it. I just put some in my hand and I just pat it all over my face. And I just absolutely have been loving it. Now, the other thing I've been loving so far from the line, but this is their cleansing balm. And this is so much like other cleansing balms that, and I love it. I think that it is very comparable. It takes off your waterproof eye makeup if you have, you know, a lot of makeup on, or if you just really need a really good cleanse, it takes it all off. And I don't feel like it leaves a really thick residue or anything like that. I do have a tendency to go in with a double cleanse after this with something that might take a little bit of residual oils off if there is any left from this, but this is fantastic for taking that first layer of makeup off, and I am in love with it. And speaking of taking off makeup and everything else, this is the value size of the CeraVe Hydrating Facial Cleanser, and I just really have been loving that it has the hydrating factor in it, but it doesn't strip your skin completely, so you don't feel like your skin's really tight afterwards. I don't feel like it leaves a film, and I love using this in the morning. So I really have been enjoying both of these as cleansers, but this one was a great find for me this month, and I really am enjoying it a lot. And then this one is the Benton Fermentation Eye Cream. So I decided to research into the ingredients, and it's chock full of ceramides and different things that are so good for your eyes. So what I've been doing is I've been using this as almost a treatment serum underneath my Suko Yakusuhara Urea Moisture Eye Cream. I love that stuff for giving super duper hydration, but I feel like this is a treatment a little bit more, and it's not super expensive. And I've had this tube for probably 6 weeks now, and I've just really enjoyed how it's playing well with that cream. I use it morning and night. I feel like I have had just a tiny bit of reduction so far in my under eye wrinkles, and so I'm really enjoying this one a lot. And then I also learned about the Secret Key Starting Treatment Essence, and this has a big word in it, so I have to get my glasses out so I can see if I can pronounce this or not for you guys. Galactomyces. I hope that's how you say it. So Penny was comparing this to the skin to, I guess that's what it is, it's SK-II, and so it might be two, it might be II. Anyway, so what I wanted to read you was the details of it. This is for normal, dry, combination, and oily skin. It helps with dullness, uneven texture, dark spots, and pores. And it says the bio ingredient derived from yeast fermentation that resembles your skin natural moisturizing factors and contains over 50 micronutrients like vitamins, minerals, amino acids, organic acids, and conditioned skin's natural function. But so Penny was saying that this is a very close dupe to it. The active ingredient is exactly the same. And she was saying buy this, not that, as a dupe. So I really have been enjoying it. I'm glad I found it. I wanted to make sure I told you guys about it immediately so that you could get the benefits from it as well. So that is it for skincare. Now, I just barely did a video on my favorite powders for dry, mature skin. And so many of you were asking, what would I recommend in that video for powder application? Okay, I have two brushes that I absolutely love that are not that expensive, and I think that they're just fantastic brushes. And this one I think I put in my last month's favorites. This is from e.l.f., and yes, it's dirty because I wash my brushes once a week, and today was not wash day. This is their large powder brush. You can get this at Walmart, and I think you can get it at Ulta too. I believe I got mine at Walmart. So I just really enjoy how soft and how fluffy this is. I enjoy that putting my powder in there doesn't mean that I'm going to have a ton of powder on my face. I always do tap my brushes like that so that the any excess powder does get off of them, and then I just go ahead and I buff it in my face. Now I use this one specifically for my finishing powders, and I use the Sonia Kashuk, and I will, again, this is a large powder brush. Make sure I link everything below, and I'll make sure that I throw up in a little ticker right here how much these are. But this brush I absolutely love for setting powder, and the reason is because it's a little bit more dense, and if I need a little bit more powder, you know, it puts it on instead of just being really a light dusting. They both do a great job, just one puts a little bit less powder on than the other, if that makes sense to you guys. Really, really soft, really beautiful brushes, and I haven't had any problems with washing them or anything, haven't lost any hairs out of them, and I've had them both for about 6 months now. So I'm really enjoying both of those, and those are what I would recommend to put powder on with. Now, in my other video where I was doing my palette declutter, I had the Rach Loves palette from Pixie Beauty, and it hadn't even come out of the box yet, and so many of you are like, oh, you're gonna love it. Well, look at mine. It is a little bit broken right here. This one came kind of shattered, but you guys, I've been so loving this, and I'm so glad that so many of you said, oh, Melissa, don't declutter that. Make sure you use it, because wow, these are so soft and they are so nice and buttery, and they make the most beautiful wash of just glass across your skin. They don't show texture, they just show shine, and it is so pretty, and I have been loving them. Now, I prefer the icy color, but a lot of people prefer the little more golden. I think that they are both absolutely gorgeous, and I've been using both of them in the inner corners of my eyes, but all three of these colors down here as well. This one is more like a champagne, and then a lavender, and then this one is like a bronzy color, and all three have those beautiful qualities of just being just so brightening and so pretty. If you have sallowness in that inner corner, you can take that lavender one and put it in there really lightly as a dusting, and it brightens that up so nice and so pretty. So this is a palette that I'm so glad I didn't declutter, and thank you guys all for helping me out with that. Colourpop came out with their Supershock highlighters. So basically it's the Supershock formula, but it's in this big, huge pan. Now, this is the size of the Marc Jacobs Omega bronzers. You guys remember that? That's how big this pan is. It's huge. But the formula in here, I love, love, love Colourpop. You guys know that I love the Supershock formula. When I talk about highlighters, most of the time I'm talking about this formula right here. I know that they have several different formulas, or not formulas, different colors out. This one is Your I Catch. And holy Moses, people, this is just incredibly beautiful. Now, you want to talk just glass, no sparkle. The Rach Loves didn't either, but this has like a property of almost being a creamy product, which I absolutely love. It comes with a, you guys can see how dirty that is. That's because the Supershock formula is like a cream product. So you make sure you put that over top of there each time. Don't lose that. It really is going to help that not dry out too quickly. And I will just show you just a tiny bit extra on this because I love this. I think it's so pretty. And I think it's one that they're going to have a big hit with. I just think this is so beautiful, you guys. I think it's just one of those ones that can be worn by so many different skin tones. And I think it's gorgeous. So when I first saw these coming out, I was like, I don't know, another highlighter, you know, but then I heard that it was the Supershock formula and I had to try it, but I'm so glad I did. Like, I need another highlighter, right? But this is really, really pretty, and I think you guys will really enjoy it. Then I have these products that I've fallen in love with from ColourPop. Okay, I'm gonna start with the concealer. This is their Pretty Fresh Concealer, and I think this is a really good one. The other one was a little bit too drying for me. This one isn't so much drying. I will tell you that I'm kind of stuck on a little bit of a different concealer train right now, but this one, when I did try it, I did find that it was really nice, and it's super good for spot concealing too. I loved the colors on it because you can choose between all different cool, warm, all kinds of stuff, and it just had a really good color for me as far as my coloring goes, and it lasted throughout the day. It stuck around. It did a really good job, so I really have been enjoying this. I would say that this is just a step above, as far as coverage and lasting power, the Maybelline Age Rewind. So if you love that, but you've been looking for a little bit more coverage wise, then I think you might really like this one. And I thought it was a great one. This is Coconut Beach. This is one of their pressed bronzers. And I love this, you guys. It's such a good color for me. Lighter. It's a lot lighter. Now, I do have the other one and I don't mind it at all. And I think I'm going to love it in the winter. But this one, it just gives me just a great glow. I am wearing, and by the way, most of these products, I can't obviously wear all the highlighters, but most of these products that I'm showing you today, I am wearing on my face, just so you guys know. So I do have this bronzer on today, and I think it's absolutely gorgeous, and I love the texture. I love how easily it blends out, but I love that about ColourPop's formula. Anyway, I love how blendable and nicely they last on your face through the day. And then I got two blushes, and I think I showed you this one. This one is from Kathleen Lights and ColourPop, and this is I Need Space. And this is the most gorgeous. It almost looks like a bronzer, doesn't it? This is just the most gorgeous nude blush. And this is just gives you a wash of pinky peach that just makes you just look like you have flushed cheeks. It doesn't make you look like you have blush on. Doesn't make you look like you have, you know, more of a pink blush or more of a warm orange blush on, peach blush on. You just have this beautiful, beautiful color on your face that just really lights up any eye look. So if I'm in doubt, I can reach for this one, and I have been loving it. And the other blush that I picked up this month is called To The 10, and this one I love too because it has that same property of not being too warm, too cool. It's just in a neutral sweet spot, and it is, I should say, it's a little bit more pink. So I think that one is probably more along the lines of a rosy tone, whereas this one right here from the Kathleen Lights one is just a very neutral color, very nude color that you can wear with anything. This one I like because this is more along the lines of my leaning towards cool undertone, but I think this one would go really great on anybody's skin tone. And can you see how both of these could be built up to be good for anybody? So love that. And this one, Lilac You A Lot. You guys have probably seen this all over everywhere. I know I have, but I really have been enjoying the purples in here and how soft these colors are. You can go in here and get one and done look. And today I actually have on this color all across my lid, and I just paired it with the Soft and Sultry palette from Milani, and I just really like it. So here are the colors right here for you guys. And I just think that if no matter what skin tone you are, you really could incorporate this into gorgeous looks. And especially if you're medium to light skin tone, this is gonna work so good for you, because you can get in here and you can do a look without having to reach for another palette if you wanted to. So you had the whole entire thing as purple. But the colors in here, I mean, look at this color right here. It's actually this color right here, and it almost shifts in a duochrome fashion. And I have never really even seen a matte do that before, and it does. And I just like it a lot. You can completely sheer that out so that it's just, you know, a really light wash of color, and you can do that with any of these. But I love every single time I come to this palette and I open it, and I either do a look with it or I use one of the colors as just a pop of color on my lid and then maybe, you know, a little bit down below. I've been really enjoying it. Now, I do love their other one, the purple one, the It's My Pleasure, but this one kind of stealing my heart right now, and I'm really enjoying using it. All right, so sharing with you a foundation that I'm really enjoying. This is Physician's Formula Organic Wear Silk Foundation Elixir with jojoba oil. I would say that this is a medium buildable coverage. I do not like their delivery system on here because it seems to just be a mess all the time. And that's, I'm not crazy about, but I do like the product inside. And I like how long this lasts on my skin. I like that it is a lighter, sheerer formula that just makes me look like I have skin instead of making me look like I have makeup on. And I really have been enjoying it. Now, I will just use like everyday use, I'll just put one coat on, and then if I have, you know, dark spots on my age spots or whatever, I'll use just a dot of concealer and then put that on, and it just, it's gorgeous. And then when I did my top 10 favorite drugstore foundations, you guys, so many of you recommended the number 7 Lift and Luminate Triple Action Serum Foundation. You're right. Why should I ever doubt you guys? You're always right. I love this foundation. It is so pretty on the skin. It just perfects my skin like no other. I love this stuff. I love that I found a perfect color. This is one that leans very cool. And of course, I will list that for you guys. It does lean very cool on my skin. I do have it on today. It just made such a gorgeous canvas on my skin, and it lasts and lasts. But I do love the formula of this. I love how pretty it is and how it does make your skin look like skin, but it's really perfected. And thank you so much for telling me about this because I'm really loving it. Okay, so I went a little bit ham this month on the lipstick train from Maybelline. What I did was I got on Amazon, and Sabrina, she had talked about some of her loves of lipsticks, and I couldn't find them anywhere except for on Amazon. And so I got some of them, and you guys, they're so pretty. There's new colors that have come out in the pinks. I actually think there's new colors across the board for Maybelline, but there was a couple of colors that were discontinued that I was like, I need to try that. So the first color that I really wanted to try is Magnificent Mauve. And you guys know, if it says mauve in the thing, in the description, I am gonna absolutely be just jumping all over that. Now, most of these are cream. So you guys know, I like a cream lipstick because I like a little bit more of a moisturizing look to my lips. So I'll put a coat on, blot, and then put another coat on, and it's a little bit more long lasting. It's got a little bit more of that mauve-y tone to it, and I love it. This one is called Nude Lust. This is one that pairs so well with just about any lip liner that you put on, and it's just got a really gorgeous, just easy way to go either cool or warm or neutral, and then, you know, pair it with a lip liner, and it just looks really stunning with it. That one is a little bit even creamier than the last one. This one is one of their new ones. This is called Born With It. This is what I have on today, and I am loving this one because this is like my lips but better color. And I just think it's just a gorgeous color. It's not one that is so pink that it makes me look like I've got super pink lips, but at the same time, it gives a really beautiful flush on the lips instead of just having, you know, too much nude. And then this one right here is called Romantic Rose. Really love this one too. A lot along the lines of this one, only more vibrant. So this is Born With It, and then this one is Romantic Rose. And the Romantic Rose I like wearing paired with just a little bit of a berry lip liner, and it looks so pretty. And then the last one I have is called Rosy Pink. And this one and the last two, I believe both of those were new. Rosy Pink is classified as a matte, but you know what, you guys, I never find that too many of these are mattes, like a super matte formula or anything. This just has a lot of pigment in it, and this one is very neutral. So this is like a nude pink color, and I just, you know, medium nude pink color, I should say, and I just think it's really pretty. I loved picking up these because I love Maybelline's formula, and I love having so many options, and they were just some absolutely gorgeous ones. So I'm so glad that I got all of those this month, and they don't cost that much. So, you know, you buy 5 of these and you're spending less than you do on a luxury lipstick. So I don't feel so bad about that. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you did. Please tell me if there's anything this month that you have been enjoying that you just feel like has been an outstanding product. You guys know that I love to hear from you guys and I love the interaction that we get. Please know that I read every single one and I appreciate you guys more than you will ever know. That's the best part of being able to be a YouTuber, is being able to meet all of you, get to know all of you, and be a part of your lives and have you be a part of mine. It makes me feel so good inside. So thank you all so very much for all of that. Hope everyone is happy and healthy, doing well. Please take care of yourselves. Have a wonderful weekend and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.